Welcome to InfoTech Research Group's Cybersecurity Series, where we partner with some of the leading minds in the field to help you make better decisions for your own organization. I'd like to welcome Sandy Silk, the Director of Information Security Education and Consulting at Harvard University, to talk about what's on everyone's mind as we approach the end of the year, what next year will look like. Thank you, Sandy, for joining us today.
Thanks, it's a pleasure.
I want to start by looking at trends. Every year, it's both necessary and healthy to plan for trends that we expect to influence the IT space, especially cybersecurity. But Sandy, it's clear that the pandemic has changed everything. What's different in cybersecurity as we try to make sense of the coming year and plan our budgets?
Well, I think for planning the budgets this year, we don't need to fight so much for cybersecurity spending that we have in past. So there's more opportunity, but what's never changing is just making sure we're looking at the right priorities. And with so much work from home going on, I think you're really looking at people, process, and technology spends and making sure you're preparing for all three of those. So a culture of security has never been more important than now.
I totally agree. And speaking of priorities, CIOs typically would look at trends. And this is the time of year when we look at trends coming in lists of fives or tens. But that may be too much to deal with this year. What should we really be focusing on?
So I think what you see a lot with those trends is very specific to types of attack, named attacks, and they tend to boil down to kind of the same things. I would say most important, look at, first of all, identity and access management. Do you know what it is connecting to your network or who it is, your accounts? Making sure it's strong authentication, which means with multi-factor, you may be pulling back from SMS text messages and more app-based. But then looking at authorization, just because something's logged in doesn't mean it needs admin privileges. And really going to the idea of least privilege is going to protect from a lot of the malware, ransomware, or useful accounts compromised by phishing. So I think focusing on those two cuts through a lot of the hype of named trends and will extend to operational technology devices too.
It's interesting because a lot of times, regardless of trends and what's new, we always just end up looking back at the fundamentals. And I agree wholeheartedly with you that identity is one that organizations have struggled with all these years. Now, we're also seeing things heating up in the regulatory front, especially in California with Proposition 24, also known as the CPRA. We're also seeing reports that many businesses are not even ready for the current regulatory landscape. How should the average IT shop plan to catch up in 2021?
So I think first and foremost, you need to be partnering with business, compliance, legal, first of all, understanding which regulations apply to different parts of your organization, because they don't apply to the entire infrastructure, entire portfolio of systems. I would look to segment those environments to which the regulations apply so that you don't end up with your whole enterprise network under audit for, say, what PCI, right? Not everything is processing credit cards or health information with HIPAA. And then really understand why you're collecting data. So many of these are privacy driven now. It's kind of like least privilege. Why am I collecting this data and for what business reason? And don't just collect information on spec, that it might be important in future, but understand why you have it and where you're sharing it and how you're protecting it and where in the environment it is.
So inventory, essentially, not just the data, but also the business process and understanding where data goes within the organization.
Which is like CIS basic number one and probably the hardest one to achieve.
Yeah. Now, switching gears here a little bit, we saw like a huge change in 2020 with the rapid shift to online courseware and collaboration platforms. What do you see us doing differently and better next year to further improve how we stay cybersecure in this remote-first landscape?
And we will be remote first. I don't think many of us are going back to being in the office 5 days a week again, or seven, whatever you worked. And collaboration is here to stay, and online courseware is here to stay. What we need to do probably better in future is governance on the add-ins to the individual applications or the APIs that are going to bridge them, and really look at, why are we considering this one? For do we have something already that would meet the needs? So do we need this additional one? And are we vetting it for security? Does it encrypt all sensitive data? Does it have good authentication and authorization? Is at least privilege? And really understanding how we are enhancing what we have this year with getting more computing power, more add-ins, but doing it in a thoughtful way.
Absolutely. It's a challenging year, but definitely an opportunity for us to do better with organizations. And as we look at 2021, if it's anything like 2020, it's clear that the way we look at cybersecurity is changing. If you are a CIO, how would you talk to stakeholders, up and including the CEO, to ensure that you optimize the organization's position?
So I always look at cybersecurity as just an operational necessity. It's part of IT, and IT is there to support the business. So really understanding what are the most crucial aspects of the business. And this is where you'll pull on business impact analysis, business continuity, disaster recovery, to understand what can't be interrupted, what costs the most for any interruption or confidentiality breach. An interruption could be operational technology, something's not available to use. And making sure you're spending correctly, you're right-sizing controls to the risk. If you overspend in prevention in an area that could have been down for a day or two with no loss, then you've actually introduced a loss. So just making sure you're optimizing business opportunities, supporting that reward, and that you can talk about the value. We're minimizing loss and maximizing opportunity.
Sandy, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us today. It was a real pleasure.
Thank you. My pleasure, and be safe.